NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has hardly opened its eyes, and the universe is new. More mysterious, more beautiful than humanity's dreams.
The James Webb Telescope, finally found it 7 trillion miles away, has recently uncovered something astonishing. Distant glows that bear a striking resemblance to city lights on Earth, emanating from Proxima Centauri B, a planet 7 trillion miles away. Could these be actual signals from an alien civilization? What if we're on the brink of the most groundbreaking discovery in human history? Prepare to be amazed as we uncover the hidden secrets of Proxima Centauri B through the lens of our state-of-the-art observatory. Exposing the secrets of alien lights. As the telescope searched the vastness of space, it found these unusual lights on Proxima Centauri B, which is far away from our own solar system. The lights resemble what we see when looking at cities on Earth at night, which leads to a thrilling idea. Maybe there's an alien city on this distant planet. This possibility has made scientists extremely excited, as it could be the breakthrough they've been waiting for. It makes us wonder if there are intelligent beings out there, possibly living in ways we haven't even thought of. And the first clues of their existence might be in front of us now. As the data came in, a scientist noticed lights blinking at odd times. Was it a message or just random? The team debated, with every flicker raising more questions. Meanwhile, a mission to investigate is at risk due to technical problems, leaving everyone anxious. The world waits, wondering if we're about to discover we're not alone in the universe. Finding these lights from such an enormous distance has amazed NASA engineers. It makes them wonder how long these lights have been shining, unnoticed, until our technology finally got advanced enough to detect them. David Kipping, an astronomer at Columbia University, has commented on the complexity of this planet. Unlike most rocky planets, which absorb sunlight and give off heat, Proxima Centauri B seems to behave differently because of its unique relationship with its star, Proxima Centauri. But here's the interesting part. This discovery isn't just about seeing lights in space. It also shows just how important the James Webb Space Telescope is in helping us understand the universe. Not only does it hint at the possibility of life beyond Earth, but it also encourages us to think about what life on other planets might be like. Could there be societies out there that function in completely different ways? The telescope is really good at capturing infrared light, which was key in discovering the unique heat patterns on Proxima B. This find is important because it helps scientists understand the planet's atmosphere. Now, researchers plan to use it even more to dig deeper into its atmosphere and see if it could support life. It is especially known for its ability to detect infrared light, which makes it great at observing Proxima Centauri B during its night cycles. While other telescopes struggle to see faint light in space, this one can pick up even the tiniest glimmers. This makes it the perfect tool to confirm whether there could be artificial lights on the dark side of the planet. The telescope is designed to detect artificial lights in space within a very specific range of frequencies, which are much narrower than those of regular starlight. The planet has an interesting relationship with its star. On the side facing the star, solar panels might capture a lot of energy, and the light bouncing off these panels is also something scientists pay attention to. As it orbits its star, it goes through cycles of day and night, much like Earth. The days are extremely hot, while the nights are much cooler. But this isn't the worst part. The temperature changes are extreme because it might not have an atmosphere. Without an atmosphere, there's nothing to trap heat during the night, causing the temperature to drop drastically after the scorching day. These wild temperature swings have caught the attention of astronomers because they could give clues about whether it has an atmosphere. The telescope, with its advanced infrared imaging, is perfect for studying the heat coming from the planet, giving us key data about its atmosphere. Even more fascinating, the telescope's orbit around Earth lines up perfectly with its own orbit. This means it can get a close look at the planet's day and night cycles every 11.2 Earth days. If it has an atmosphere, the next step would be to study what's in it and see if it could support life. Markers like oxygen, water vapor, and methane would be big hints that life could exist there. If these are found, it would strongly suggest that it might have conditions that could sustain life. But capturing and analyzing light from the planet's atmosphere is no easy task. It is up for it, though its main job is to measure things like water vapor, carbon dioxide, and methane. Still, this data is critical for understanding its atmosphere. It is still hard at work searching the skies. even though it has a hard time finding bonded oxygen, which is an important clue in the search for life. It does, however, keep a close eye on other important elements like ozone, which can tell us a lot about whether a planet has a strong atmosphere. As scientists go through the data from this telescope, their excitement about uncovering the secrets of faraway planets grows. Each piece of information brings us a little closer to answering one of the biggest questions of all. Is Earth the only place in the universe with life? Right now, it can only observe a handful of planets that are relatively close to us. To take a deeper look at these distant planets, attention is turning to other advanced tools, like the Extremely Large Telescope, ELT, which is expected to begin operations by the year 2028. This new telescope will offer a much more detailed look at these planets, helping scientists understand whether they could support life. Even though it is doing incredible work, the data it provides is shaping the way we think about the universe. The information we are getting today will not only change our view of the cosmos, but will also help shape the future of space exploration. Future space telescopes are being designed to block out the bright light from distant stars, similar to how we use our hand to block the sun so we can see better. This will help scientists get a clearer view of the faint reflections from planets and examine their atmospheres to see if they might support life. But it's not easy to tell if gases in a planet's atmosphere are from living things or from natural processes like volcanic eruptions. With the stage set by these intriguing findings, we now turn our attention to how these discoveries shape our next steps into the cosmic unknown. The role of James Webb in finding life beyond Earth. Scientists are working hard to improve their methods of telling the difference between these signals, which will make it easier to find real signs of life. This search is not just about finding life, though. It's also about learning more about these distant worlds. Right now, the James Webb Space Telescope is giving us early glimpses of what future space explorations might uncover. Every discovery pushes the boundaries of what we know and helps us better understand our place in the universe. For as long as humans have been around, we've wondered if we are alone in the universe. Today, this telescope is out there, searching different parts of the sky, looking for signs of life beyond Earth. The idea that life could exist elsewhere in the universe is becoming more accepted, and scientists are working hard to prove it. In 1984, two American astronomers, Jill Tarter and Thomas Pearson, started the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, SEETI. They set up a nonprofit group to look for radio signals from space using the Allen Telescope Array's 42 dishes in California's mountains. These signals can travel great distances with little interference, making them a key tool in the search for life. For over 30 years, the SETI has been listening for signals from alien civilizations without picking up anything clear. But despite this, Jill Tarter remains hopeful. She believes that with today's advanced technology, we are closer than ever to making a big discovery. Tarter hopes that this mission will become a global effort, bringing people together in the shared goal of finding life beyond Earth. Recently, the scientific community got excited about a new report from NASA. It hinted that this telescope might have captured something as remarkable as city lights on a faraway planet. Positioned 1 million miles from Earth, it lets us explore the mysteries of the universe like never before, revealing details that were once out of reach. This telescope is designed to find things we couldn't see before. It helps scientists understand how galaxies, stars, and planets are formed. Using its high-tech camera and special filters, astronomers can now study the colors around distant celestial bodies more closely. These tools help them learn about the physical and chemical makeup of planets and stars by examining different wavelengths of light. But it doesn't just look, it also examines the atmospheres of other planets for signs of life. With its unmatched ability to study the depths of space and time, the telescope has made groundbreaking discoveries. One of the most surprising finds is that the universe contains much more mass in large galaxies than scientists originally thought. This has forced them to rethink their ideas about how the universe began and how it continues to expand. Each new discovery from the telescope deepens our interest in alien worlds and helps us better understand the potential for life beyond our own planet. As we continue to push the boundaries of space exploration, it gives us new insights into distant worlds. But here's the interesting part. While we're learning more, we're also raising bigger questions. About 20 years ago, the space beyond our own solar system was mostly unknown, We had very little information about the planets orbiting other stars. Fast forward to today, and astronomers have found over 4,000 exoplanets. This shows just how far we've come in both our curiosity and technology. NASA, a leader in space exploration, believes this is only the beginning. They think our galaxy alone could have trillions of planets, each holding its own mysteries. The drive to explore space and find out what's out there hasn't stopped. Scientists continue searching for any sign of life beyond Earth, and sometimes they get really close. One big moment happened when the Galileo spacecraft, which was orbiting Jupiter, found evidence that suggested there might be plant life on a faraway planet. This was a groundbreaking discovery. Scientists found something called a biosignature, which is basically a clue that life might exist. In this case, it was the vegetation red edge, VRE, a way to detect plants based on how they reflect light. With this in mind, the telescope is now set to explore even deeper. Part of its mission is to find planets that are in just the right spot around their stars, the habitable zone, where conditions might support life. On top of that, new tools like the virtual reality engine, VRE, could completely change how we search for planets that could support not only simple life forms, but maybe even intelligent ones. But here's the interesting part. This new phase of exploring space is all about trying to understand the vast unknown areas of the universe. Picture this: sunlight shining through the atmospheres of distant planets, breaking into different wavelengths of light. These wavelengths get absorbed by the atoms and molecules in the planet's atmosphere, creating unique patterns called spectral signatures. These are like cosmic fingerprints, and scientists use them to learn more about the possibility of life on those far-off planets. Scientists believe that when a planet passes in front of a star, the telescope will capture the light passing through the planet's atmosphere. This means it might help us understand what distant planets' atmospheres are made of. Planets similar in size to Earth usually have a mix of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and oxygen in their atmospheres. Some of these planets might support life, but if scientists find strange or unusual chemicals, it could point to completely different types of life or even advanced civilizations. For example, consider chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs, chemicals humans made mostly for cooling systems. If the JWST detects these on another planet, it could mean intelligent life is there. This kind of discovery would open up new possibilities for astronomers, allowing them to study planets' atmospheres and imagine the possibility of life far beyond our own galaxy. As we continue this journey, the subsequent section will examine how these technological marvels could transform our future explorations. Life in extreme cosmic conditions. Thinking about life beyond Earth brings up endless possibilities, many of which are very different from the life we know. We often imagine life needing mild, stable environments, but the reality could be much more varied. Take extremophiles, for instance. These are tiny creatures that challenge what we think about where life can exist. They can live in extreme conditions, like very high temperatures of over 250 degrees Fahrenheit, or in environments with pH levels as low as 3. Their ability to thrive in such harsh conditions shows how flexible life can be, even in places we might think of as uninhabitable. But this is just the beginning. As we keep searching for planets that might support life, discovering it in these unlikely places could change how we see the universe. We're only just starting to understand what's really possible. Space exploration is a huge field with many different paths, which means searching for life beyond Earth has to be broad and thorough. Planets like Earth, orbiting stars like our Sun, are a great place to start. But it's also important to keep an open mind and look in other, less obvious places. One example is exoplanets, planets outside our solar system, that orbit red dwarf stars. These stars are very common in the universe, though they aren't as bright or warm as our Sun. However, they create unique conditions that could still support life. Plus, red dwarfs live much longer than stars like our Sun, giving life plenty of time to develop. A good example of this is the TRAPPIST-1 system. It has a faint red dwarf star and 7 rocky planets orbiting it, which are similar to Earth. Out of these 7 planets, 3 are in what's called the habitable zone. This means they might have liquid water, which is key for life as we know it. Although the TRAPPIST-1 star is smaller and cooler than our Sun, it still gives off enough light that could make life possible. By studying this light, scientists are trying to learn more about what it might be like to live on one of these planets. Thanks to the James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, we now know this system is around 41 light years away from us, in the constellation of Leo, and is an exciting place to keep exploring. NASA scientist Ward Howard, who leads a research team from the University of Colorado Boulder, is really excited about these discoveries. He pointed out that with the new technology of the JWST, we can now study planets around other stars more closely, especially those with atmospheres that might be like Earth's. Understanding the stars themselves helps us get a better idea of what the planets around them might be like. But even though TRAPPIST-1 is fascinating, it's not the only star worth paying attention to. One star that stands out is Proxima Centauri, which is only about 4.25 light years away from our Sun. This makes it our closest stellar neighbor. Proxima Centauri doesn't shine very brightly and is tough to see in the night sky from Earth because it doesn't give off much light. Any planet that could support life would need to be much closer to the star than Earth is to the Sun. On a typical day in late August 2016, a group of astronomers made a thrilling discovery, a planet that is about one-third bigger than Earth. This planet is in the habitable zone around a star called Proxima Centauri. The habitable zone is important because it gets just the right amount of sunlight, enough to melt ice and possibly create conditions where life could exist. The planet, called Proxima B, orbits close to its dim red star, Proxima Centauri, and is only about 4.6 million miles away from it. Since it's so close, the planet has to deal with tough environmental challenges. One of the biggest problems is the strong solar winds coming from the star, which could strip away the atmosphere over time. Even with these challenges, the planet still gets enough light to keep its surface warm. This warmth could help keep oceans of liquid water, a key ingredient for life. But because it orbits so closely to its star, the planet is tidally locked. This means one side is always in sunlight, while the other side is stuck in darkness. This creates a planet with two very different environments. One side always facing the light, the other side always in the dark. It's similar to how the same side of the moon always faces Earth. Although the star is smaller, it still gives off enough energy that life could potentially survive there, maybe in ways similar to life on Earth. Did the James Webb Space Telescope really find evidence of alien civilizations? Or are we just seeing what we want to believe? What do you think? Please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts below.